naked mole rats invade neighboring colonies and kidnap babies. Scientists find secret to uncrushable beetle strength. Aliens on 1,000 nearby stars could be watching us. And Nokia will build the moon's first cellular network. Welcome to the What the Facts channel. This is Science News Summary, where we will cover the most interesting news about everything science-related that happens during the last week. Our topics range from medicine, neurology, and biology, to physics, technology, and space. So if you've had enough negativity in the press and you're looking for some uplifting news, then this show is just for you. Let's get started. Ants are one of the most successful groups of animals on the planet. They're social insects, and their teamworking abilities have long since been identified as one of the key factors leading to their success. Ants are famously able to lift or drag objects many times their own weight and transport these objects back to their colony. But with previous research having focused on social aspects of an ant colony, looking at an individual ant has been somewhat neglected. Now, researchers at the Okinawa Institute and Sorbonne University in Paris have investigated why individual worker ants are so strong. They were taking X-ray images and creating 3D models of their thorax, the central unit of their bodies, to analyze their muscles and internal skeleton. In flying insects, the wing muscles occupy a major part of the thorax, sometimes more than 50%. This means that other muscles, which are used to support and move the head, legs, and abdomen, are constrained and squeezed up against the exoskeleton. But once the constraints of flight are removed, all that space in the thorax is open, which the researchers surmised would allow the remaining muscles to expand and reorganize. This means that the muscle groups have expanded in volume, giving the worker ants more strength and power. The naked mole rat is loved for having the most bizarre mammalian psychic powers. They resist cancer, resist the normal mammalian aging process, survive for almost 20 minutes without oxygen, and can tolerate surprisingly high levels of pain. Along with their bigger, hairy cousins, Damaraland mole rats are the only known eusocial animals, the highest classification of sociality. That means that adult colonial members belong to two or more overlapping generations, care cooperatively for the young, and are divided into reproductive and non-reproductive castes. This phenomenon is most common to insects, especially ants, bees, wasps, and termites. New research suggests there's brute power in those numbers. Like ants or termites, the mole rats go to battle with rival colonies to conquer their lands. In the early 1990s, researchers caught and released naked mole rats to track them for a long-term field study in Kenya. They found 26 colonies expanded their burrows into neighboring colonies. A year after checking one of these colonies, they found two pups in an invading colony looked to have been from an invaded colony. Naked mole rat kidnapping behavior had previously been witnessed in the unnatural conditions of a laboratory, but this is the first time it's been confirmed in the wild. If this is the case, the team believes fierce aggression between naked mole rat colonies may be driving the evolution of large group sizes, and slavery allows expanding colonies to increase their competitive advantage over neighbors. Beetles can withstand bird pecks, animal stomps, and even being rolled over on by a car. Now scientists are studying what the bug's crush-resistant shell could teach them about designing stronger planes and buildings. So how does the seemingly indestructible insect do it? The species, aptly named the diabolical ironclad beetle, owes its might to an unusual armor that is layered and pieced together like a jigsaw, according to the study. To understand what gives the inch-long beetle its strength, researchers first tested how much squishing it could take. The species, which can be found in Southern California's woodlands, withstood compression of about 39,000 times its own weight, the equivalent of a 150-pound or 70-kilogram person resisting the crush of about 14 blue whales. Researchers then used electron microscopes and CT scans to examine the beetle's exoskeleton and figure out what made it so strong. As is often the case for flightless beetles, the species Elytra, the blades that normally sheath wings, had toughened over time. The team realized this cover also benefited from special, jigsaw-like bindings and a layered architecture. The beetle study is part of an $8 million project funded by the U.S. Air Force. It is the latest effort to borrow from the natural worlds to solve human problems. There are about 1,000 star systems where aliens, if they existed, could be watching us from afar, new research suggests. Over the course of the last decade, astronomers have found exoplanets orbiting distant stars using a simple formula: keep an eye on a star and wait for it to suddenly dim. That dimming is a sign of a planet passing between the star and the telescope. Analyzing how the light changes as the star dims can reveal the chemical contents of the planet's atmosphere. But this method only works for planets whose orbits happen to take them between their host stars and Earth. In a new paper, researchers flipped that formula on its head, asking, Which nearby stars are lined up properly for their inhabitants to see Earth transit in front of the sun? Would any life forms in those star systems be able to detect signs of us, the living things on Earth's surface? The answer is yes, it turns out, for a great number of nearby stars. Within 326 light years, the researchers found there are 1,004 with vantage points to spot Earth. Of those, 508 have viewing angles that would give them at least 10 hours of observational data every time Earth passed between that location and the sun. Ideal conditions for spotting this little rocky planet and the signs of life in its atmosphere. However, 77% of the stars studied are red dwarfs, bodies that are very unsuitable for the existence of life. Only 6% are of the same type as our sun, the stars around which planets capable of theoretically carrying life can orbit. NASA just landed a spacecraft on an asteroid Bennu and sucked up a sample of dust and rock from the surface. In just 5 to 10 seconds, the probe has collected samples from the asteroid's surface. It's set to bring these pieces of Bennu back to Earth later. But it seems that the spacecraft might have got a bit overexcited and gathered so many rocks that now its door won't close properly. NASA officials confirmed that a rock is wedged in the container door, allowing other rocks to spill back out into space. It's got experts worried about exactly how much material will make it back to Earth. The team initially planned to conduct a sample measurement to see how much material was in the collector and assess whether another run was needed. However, later examination showed that there might be hundreds of grams of asteroid debris already inside OSIRIS-REx, so NASA has decided to focus on transferring the remaining material into the sample return capsule, which will keep it secure on the return journey to Earth. OSIRIS-REx has been orbiting Bennu since December 2018, scanning the asteroid and collecting as much data as possible. It's set to leave in March 2021, samples in tow, then reach Earth on September 24, 2023. The asteroid rocks and dirt will then make their way to labs around the world, where scientists can study them for clues about the solar system's early days and the role that carbon-rich space rocks like Bennu may have played in helping life get started on Earth. And here is the last piece of news for this week. The Finnish technology company recently announced that its Nokia Bell Labs division will build the Lunar Communication System. It said NASA will put the equipment on a lunar lander. The spacecraft is expected to reach the moon's surface in late 2022. Earlier this month, NASA announced it had awarded $370 million to 14 companies to provide technology for the moon landing program. The Nokia agreement was included in NASA's latest awards to private companies. The space agency said it is paying the company $14.1 million to build the mobile network. Nokia said its network will provide critical communications for work astronauts will need to perform on the moon. This will include remote control of lunar vehicles and other equipment, real-time navigation activities, and high-quality video streaming. The equipment includes a base station, antennas, and computer software programs. All the equipment will be designed to survive difficult launches, lunar landings, and extreme conditions in space. The deal is a win for Nokia, which has been competing with China's Huawei and Sweden's Ericsson for lucrative 5G contracts. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you enjoyed hearing some positive news. If you did, and you want to support this channel, please share this video with your friends, or consider hitting the subscribe button. This is Alex, the voice of the What the Fact channel. That's all for today's episode, so stay curious, and see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.